Hi there, welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. We will now talk about the inverse square law in physics, which is important under many circumstances. For example, if you look at this sprinkler here, you have the picture of a sprinkler. If the sprinkler is giving off certain amount of water at each second, if you are close to the sprinkler, you'll get really wet. Many drops will reach you. As you get further and further away from the sprinkler, the water gets spread around and fewer drops will reach you. You get less wet as you get further. The inverse square law tells you how much less wet do you get. Is it a little bit less wet? Is it very much less wet? So the inverse square law is important for luminosity. If there is a star right there in the center of this picture, emitting certain amount of energy, certain amount of light every second. If a person observer is very close to that star, it will see it as something very bright. A lot of photons will be reaching that person that's close to the star. As a person moves further and further from the star, the same amount of light gets distributed over a larger area. The light gets diluted. It's less bright. So in the outermost shell, there's less photons, less light arriving in each one of those squares than in this shell and then in this shell. You can try to see it yourself by getting a balloon. Get a balloon, draw a bunch of little things in there. And if you draw it when they are small, you see that they are very close to one another, because they have a small area to fit into it. Now, if you expand the balloon, if you blow it, you give more space for those, for whatever drawing you made here, and they get more diluted, just like the luminosity does, just like the water in the sprinkler does. There's less of it further away. So the inverse square law for luminosity says that the brightness, B, depends on the luminosity, the amount of light that the object is really emitting, so the luminosity is the energy per unit of time, divided by the area of this sphere. If the sphere is small, the object will be really bright. If the sphere is larger, the brightness will decrease, according to the square of the size of the object. So the apparent brightness decreases as 1 over r squared. That's why it's called the inverse square law. Okay? So if the distance doubles, the brightness is decreased by 1/4, because it's 1 over 2 squared. If the distance halves, the brightness increases 4 times, because 0.5 squared, 1 over that will give you 4. Now, the inverse square law happens in many other laws in physics. So I just showed you brightness and luminosity, the relationship between brightness, luminosity, and how far away one is from the object that it's emitting the luminosity. But look, this is similar to what we see for gravity also. Gravity is also an inverse square law. The force of attraction gets smaller with the inverse of the square of the distance. The electrostatic force is also an inverse square law. These are all inverse square laws. So this inverse square law is really powerful in astronomy in many different ways. So it's just a way of quantifying how much dimmer an object becomes as it moves further and further away from the source that's illuminating it. I hope that helps. I'll see you next time.